Hey coders, Darren here, and today we are working on a topic that was requested by Repaler. He said that he might have had some trouble saying exactly what it was that he wanted, but if I understood correctly, he was trying to get 8-directional movement on a character relative to the camera orientation. So no matter where the camera is facing, the horizontal and vertical input keys would rotate the player in the expected way. So there are a couple of requirements for this system. For the player controller, we need 8-directional movement, and the player should stop and face his current direction when there is no input. Now for the camera controller, we need to follow the player on the player's X and Z plane, and we need to smooth rotation around the player in 45 degree increments. Okay, so this is the scene that we're going to be working in today. All we have is really a plane, a cube, a light, and a camera. Now, this plane I just got from the standard assets prototyping assets. So you can go up to assets, import package, and choose prototyping, and you can get this plane. You can just drag it in as a prefab. Okay, but let's go ahead and just start things off. We need to create a Mario controller. We'll just call it Mario controller. And we need to create a camera controller. This Mario controller will go on our player, which is actually just a cube. So we'll drag that up on there. And then we need the camera controller. So create C# script and call this camera controller. And we'll drag that onto our camera. Okay, now we'll open up the Mario controller script. Okay, so here's our script, and I'm just going to start off on a clean slate here. There's two public members that we need. We need a public float for velocity, and we can initialize this to something arbitrary. It doesn't matter because we can modify that later. We also need a public float for turn speed, so how fast can our character turn. Then we'll need a vector2 to store our input. That's our .x for horizontal and .y for vertical. And we'll need a float for our current angle because our angle is going to be in 45 degree increments and we need to know how to rotate the player. Okay, we'll also need a quaternion. Now these are private members that we're listing now. These only need to be modified within the script so that we'll have our target rotation that we're trying to rotate to. And then we'll also have a transform property for our camera so we can keep track of our camera's angles. Now we have two main requirements for this script. Those requirements I'll add as comments up here. I'll do triple line comments. Unfortunately, Visual Studio Code doesn't automate the triple line comments. So our two requirements, the first one would be 8-directional movement. And then the second one is stop and face current direction when input is absent, okay? So we'll keep those up there as a reminder for what this script is really trying to do. All right, so let's go ahead and initialize our camera transform. And to do that, we can access camera.main, camera.main.transform. So it's that easy. Okay, now we want to write out the skeleton of this script. Okay, so I took the liberty to add comments to these so you guys can read those as we program. But we have four main functions: get input, calculate direction, rotate, and move. So let's go ahead and add our functions in our update. So this is all these four functions are going to be part of our update loop. So the first thing we're going to do is get input. Okay, now we also said that we want to stop and face our current direction when the input is absent. So we can do that check here because after we get our input, we don't want to do anything if there is no input registered. So we can say if the absolute value of our input.x is less than 1, and we're going to be working with raw input, so the value could only be 0 or 1 or negative 1, but can't be any value interpolated between those. So by saying less than 1, we know that there's no input on the x. And remember, we're using the absolute value. So we'll say the input.x absolute value and the absolute value of the input.y. So that's our horizontal and vertical input. So if both of those are less than 1, we can just return. And that's going to fulfill this requirement number 2. Okay, now after that, we can just call our three other functions, calculate direction, rotate, and move. Okay, so how do we get input? Well, we only need to satisfy the input.x and input.y variables. we can say input.x is equal to input.getAccessRaw because we only want we don't want any interpolated values. So we can say horizontal, and that will give us our AD left arrow, right arrow keys. And then we can say input.y is equal to input.getAccessRaw vertical. And our vertical axis is going to give us WS, the up and arrow keys. Okay, now we want to calculate direction. So we'll just go from top down, I suppose. So how do we calculate direction? Well, we have this float up here called angle. And that's going to be the value that we're setting to determine our Euler angle.y. So that value is going to be initially equal to the tangent of the a tan squared of our input.x and input.y. So we can say angle is equal to mathf.a tan 2. I believe that's lowercase t. And the two parameters that we're putting in here are input.x, input.y. I'm not going to talk too much about this. This is a simple geometric function. If you want to learn more about a tan 2, you can look that up. Okay, and then what we want to do is basically convert this into degrees. This is going to give us radians. Again, this has to do with some geometric functions, but this angle currently is in radians, so if we just use this right now in our Euler angle.y, it's going to give us some unexpected values. So to convert this, we can say angle is equal to mathf.rad to deg, which is radians to degrees, and multiply that by angle. So this mathf rad to deg is not a function, it's actually just a constant value, and we multiply that by our angle. So now we have it in terms of our, in terms of like 0 to 360 angles or values. Now what we need to do is make sure that we are moving this or rotating relative to our camera. So all we need to do, and we don't need to do any fancy vector math, which is good. All we need to do is say angle plus equals cam.euler angles.y. So, I mean, think about this. All we're doing is saying, what is our camera's y angle? And then all we're going to do is add our calculated angle to that. And you'll see how powerful that is. When I first attempted this problem, I was trying to calculate the different vectors that my player needed to move along. And that is just a more complicated approach. While it may work, this is much easier. Okay, so let's go on to these much more simple functions, rotate and move. For rotating, we just need to calculate our target rotation based on the angle that we just calculated. So we can say equals quaternion.euler, and then we pass a vector 3. I've said this before in previous tutorials, but the Euler function will take a vector 3 as Euler angles and convert that into a quaternion for our target rotation. So this will take a vector 3. We can say the x rotation that we want is 0, the y rotation that we want is angle, and the z rotation that we want is 0. So it'll take the Euler angles and convert that into a quaternion using this Euler function. Once we have the target rotation that we want to move to, we can slurp to that so it looks more smooth. So we can say our transform.rotation is equal to quaternion.slurp. That's sort of like a, you can use quaternion.lerp, I believe. And to be quite honest, I can't tell you the exact difference between those. I believe slurp just works better with rotation. So I'm not going to try to lie to you guys and act like I know exactly what's going on there, but this will, you can use slurp or lerp, and that'll just make your rotation a little bit smoother. Transform, if anybody knows exactly the difference between slurp and lerp, then definitely put that in the comments so we can talk about that. So the first parameter is your current rotation, second parameter is your target rotation, and the third parameter is how fast you want to go from your current to your target. So we have a turn speed variable up here, a public variable, and we can use that down here. So we can say turn speed times time dot delta time to make sure that's frame independent. Okay, so that's all we need for rotate. Now moving, all we're doing is moving along our player's forward. So we can just say transform.position plus equals transform.forward. And you know, this is not really using a rigid body model, which is why I'm just moving the position in this way. But if you're using a rigid body model, all of this code will be fairly similar. You'll just be moving the velocity instead. So we can say transform.position equals transform.forward times velocity times time.delta time. And velocity is a variable that we defined up top. We made that public. Okay, and that's all we need for our Mario controller. Let's go back to Unity and see how this works. Okay, so it looks like I have an error on line 27. Some of you might have caught what I did wrong, but let's go back and see what's going on there. Okay, so one thing I see right off the bat is this needs to be mathf, not just math. And I didn't actually say and here. So we have two oops, that's not what I wanted. So double ampersand. These are two conditions here, so we need to separate that by and. So if the input.x is less than 1 and input.y is less than 1. Okay, some of you might have caught that. Let's go back and see if that fixes things. Okay, so let's run this. And actually what I want to do is sort of offset the camera so we have a better view. And I'll sort of rotate down on it. Okay, so we'll run and see if we have our 8 directional movement. Okay, it looks good. So if I just press W, I'll go forward. If I press S, I'll turn around and come back. Now I'll just sort of test the other rotations, the diagonal rotations, and those look good. And also, when I release my input, my player is facing the current direction that he was left off in. So that was one of our requirements, and the other requirement was our 8 directional movement. So our Mario controller is done. All we need to do is work on the camera controller and make sure that that is moving properly. Okay, so here we are on our camera controller. We'll start off with a blank slate as always, and we'll start off by defining some public members. We'll have a target that we're going to be looking at, which is the Mario controller. We'll have a vector 3 for the offset position of basically the relative position to the target. So what is the offset position? So how far off on the X from the player, how far off on the Y, and how far off on the Z from the player is the camera going to be? We'll have a float for move speed, and we can set these to sort of arbitrary values. Float for turn speed, and this is going to be how fast the camera actually looks at the player. Move speed is how fast the camera moves to the offset relative to the target. And then we'll have one more public float for snap speed. We can call this smooth speed as well. It's not really going to be snapping. This value is going to be how fast the camera moves on the 45 degree increments around the player. So we'll see exactly what's going on with that in just a second after we finish this script. Okay, now we have some public or some private members that we need to create. Of course, a quaternion for the target rotation. That's going to be used to actually look at the player. Then we need a vector 3 for target position. And we'll need a bool for snap rotating. I'll just call this smooth rotating. This boolean is going to determine whether or not we're currently trying to move to a new rotation around the player. We'll see why we need that in just a second. So I'll go ahead and create the skeleton of this just like I did for the player controller, and we'll be able to work from there. Okay, so once again, I added some comments along with the skeleton. You guys can read those as we work. Let's go ahead and fill out the requirements for the update loop. We're just going to be calling these functions based on how we want the camera to operate. So the first thing that we want to do is make sure we move with our target. The second thing is look at target. So we're moving and looking at the target. And then we want to sort of call this coroutine based on a couple inputs. So if we press one input, then we will rotate around the left side of the player. If we press another input, we'll rotate around the right side of the player. One thing I forgot was some requirements at the top of this script, so let me go ahead and add that. Okay, so we sort of briefly went over these in the beginning of this tutorial. The first requirement is follow on the player's XZ plane. This is pretty much controlled by our offset position. You'll see how we do some tricks to ensure that requirement is fulfilled. The second one is to smooth rotations around the player in 45 degree increments. That's going to be done with our rotate around target. I just realized my R is capitalized. Our rotate around target coroutine. Okay, so you know I like to do this to make sure that I have sort of a clear vision for the class. Now, in our update function, let's go ahead and finish. We want to make sure we're checking for a couple inputs to determine which direction we want to rotate around the target. So we can say if input.getKeyDown, and these keys that I'm choosing are arbitrary. You can choose any keys that you want. I'm going to choose keycode.g, and I'll also use h. So g will be for rotating around the left side, and h will be used for rotating around the right side. So g is left, h is right. And we also want to make sure that we only call this coroutine whenever we aren't smooth rotating. So we'll say if this input key is down and we are not smooth rotating, then we can call start coroutine. So start coroutine, rotate around target. And that takes a parameter, so I'll add a comma. And since we're pressing G, we want to rotate around the left side. So that's actually going to be positive 45. And for pressing H, that'll be negative 45. And I'll add that second condition for when we press H as well. Okay, so that's all we need for our update cycle. Now let's talk about move with target. We'll do our top-down approach like we did with the player controller. Move with target is just going to be two lines. We just need to make sure we get our target position, and that's going to be equal to target.position plus our offset position. So that vector 3 up here that we're going to determine publicly from our inspector, we're just adding the target position plus that offset position, and that's going to be the position that we're lerping to. So our transform.position, so the camera's transform.position, is going to be equal to vector3.lerp, our current, which is transform.position, and our target, which is target pause, and the time that it takes to get there, or the speed that we're moving to get there, is move speed times time.delta time. Okay, that's all we need with move to target. Look at target is similar to, it's not really similar to the player's rotation, but what we'll do is we'll say the target rotation is equal to quaternion dot look rotation. If you know anything about vector math, then you know that getting the look vector is achieved by subtracting the current position from the target position. So we can say the parameter that's going to be passed here is our target dot position minus our current position, transform dot position. And that will give us a quaternion to lerp towards so that we're actually looking at our target. We can say transform.rotation is equal to quaternion.slurp. First parameter is our current, transform.rotation. Second parameter is our target, which is target rotation. Third parameter is going to be our speed. We defined above turn speed publicly times time.delta time. So we defined that turn speed above. Okay, finally, we want to rotate around our target. This is a coroutine, so this will actually operate independently of the update cycle. So what we want to do here is define a velocity, because we're going to be using a smooth damp function that's going to take a ref vel or ref velocity, which is modified by the function. So vector3 vel, we need to initialize that to vector3.0. We're not actually going to be doing anything with this other than passing it to the smooth damp function. Vector 3 target offset pause, which is going to be equal to quaternion dot Euler 0 angle 0 times offset position. So what's going on here? Well, you can rotate a vector 3 point around a certain position. Right now, this would be rotating it around this line would be rotating it around a vector3.0 position, because I'm not actually adding anything to it. But essentially, what we're saying is we're going to rotate the offset position by this angle. So x, 0, y is angle, and z is 0. So we're taking and we're rotating the offset position by this vector 3 Euler angle. And this is how we do that. We use the quaternion.Euler, and that's going to return a rotated position, which is why this is a vector 3. So this line is a little bit complicated. If you guys want to hear more about that, or if you're confused about it, then let me know in the comments. It's a little bit difficult to explain quaternion functions, but that's what's going on there. So we also want to keep track of a distance. So float dist is equal to vector 3.distance, offset pause, target offset pause. And so what I'm checking here is we're going to be running this coroutine while the target, or while our current offset position is within a certain range of our target. And this gives us the ability to sort of smoothly rotate around our camera. So that's what all of this is for. So what I want to do is say I'm going to rotate all we're doing is modifying the offset position. So I'm going to modify the offset position while that distance is greater than a certain value. And I'll say 0.02f. Now I can say, one thing I need to make sure I do no matter what is yield return null. I could also do yield return wait for seconds, but I want to make sure that this is being called every frame. And there's two things that I'm going to do. First, I'll do this because I already have this line. So we want to make sure that while we're in this while loop, we're updating the distance between the offset and the target offset. Otherwise, we're going to do a smooth damp, which is it's a smoother version of lerp in my experience. And we're going to do a smooth damp from offset position to the target offset position. And remember that offset position is what we're using to move with the target. Okay, so offset position is going to be equal to vector 3 dot smooth damp. And this the parameters for this function are similar to lerp. So the first parameters are current, so offset pause. Second parameters are target offset pause. Third parameter is going to be a ref vel. Remember, we defined vel up here, and this is where we're using it. And we don't need to do anything else. This is this velocity is basically just keeping track of the speed that we are lerping to currently. The fourth parameter is the actual time that we want it to take. So up top we have something called smooth speed, and that's equal to 0.5f right now. So by inserting smooth speed to this fourth parameter, we're sort of saying that our offset position will reach the target offset position within 0.5 seconds. And that's an approximation. Okay, now once we exit this while loop, once the distance is close enough, we want to make sure that we say that our smooth rotating bool is equal to false. That gives us the ability to actually start the coroutine again by pressing G or H. And then we also want to make sure that our offset position is exactly the target offset position, because we might be exiting out of this loop when they're not exactly the same. So when this loop exits, we want to make sure that we are actually saying that the offset position is exactly the target offset position. Okay, now I think this is done. Let's go back to Unity and see if it works. Okay, so back in Unity, and we need to make sure that we're dragging our player onto our target. And we also have this offset position. So we'll say that the camera is 10 units above the target and 10 units behind the target. So we'll keep these settings and we'll go ahead and run. Okay, so it looks like our camera is following the player as we would expect. Okay, so what I want to do is let's first make sure that our rotations are working properly. So let me press G, so that goes to about 45. Press it again, that goes to about 90. Yeah, so it looks like these are working. It shouldn't be letting me continuously try to rotate, which means my smooth rotating bool was never set. Let's go back to our script and see what we need to fix. Okay, so the smooth rotating is set to false here. It's never actually set to true, which means it's always false, which means I can always call this coroutine. That's going to mess things up a bit. So I want to make sure that when I enter this coroutine, I'm saying smooth rotating is equal to true. Now let's go back to Unity and make sure that's fixed. Okay, so I'm playing now. So let's just make sure that we can press G over and over again, and it's not going to mess up. So I'm just pressing it really fast right now. So it looks like it's fixed now. And so you can see the problem that we ran into and why we need that Boolean. That's going to just make sure that our rotations will never snap anywhere other than the 45 degree increments. Now if I press H, I go around the other way. Perfect. Okay, so now what we want to do is sort of the ultimate test, what this video is for, and that is when we rotate the camera, I can still press W and the player will still move forward relative to the camera angle. And to prove that that's sort of working the way it should, I'm just going to hold the forward button while I do a rotation. So I'll hold W and I'll press G. And look at that. So it just moves. I'm just holding W and it's moving the way it should be as it rotates. All right. So everything seems to be working exactly the way we wanted it to. Okay, let's go all the way around. So it looks like it's working perfectly. And I'm going to conclude the tutorial with that. You can play around with the move speed and turn speed settings. You'll get some sort of different looks with that. So let's try to go. So now it's following a little bit slower. That might be more of a Super Mario World sort of feel there. But go ahead and play around with those settings, see if you like it. But that's going to conclude this tutorial. So thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next video.